الله الرحمن الرحيم الملك القدوس السلام المؤمن المهيمن العزيز الجبار. الله الرحمن الرحيم الملك القدوس السلام المؤمن المهيمن العزيز الجبار.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Welcome to another episode about the beautiful names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In this episode, we are going to talk about Al-Hafiz and then Al-Muqit. And in that order which we have followed, Al-Hafiz comes as 39th in number, and then Al-Muqit the 40th. As far as Al-Hafiz is concerned, it is coming from Hifz. And Hifz means to protect something, to guard something, to preserve something. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said, Inna nahnu nazzalna dhikra wa inna lahu lahafidhun. We have revealed this reminder, which is Al-Quran, and we are going to protect it. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described himself with this attribute of Hafiz, like the verse of Surah Saba, وَرَبُّكَ عَلَىٰ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ حَفِيظٌ. And your Lord is upon everything Hafiz. And what does it mean here? You can say that he is protecting them, he is protecting everything, and also he is watchful upon them. And that is more appropriate, because the meaning of Hafiz is not only to protect. Sometimes it means to watch as well. Let us take the first meaning, which is to preserve and protect. For example, in Ayat al-Kursi, وَسِعَ كُرْسِيُّهُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَلَا يَؤُدُهُ حِفْظُهُمَا وَهُوَ الْعَلِيُّ الْعَظِيمُ. His kursi, that is the footstool of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is so wide that all the heavens and the earth can come into it. And then, وَلَا يَؤُدُهُ حِفْزُهُمَا. And it is not a burden upon him to protect them. And he is high, he is great. And in the same way, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said about the angels who protect us, who protect the human beings. In the beginning of Surah Ar-Ra'd, verse number 11, لَهُ مُعَقِّبَاتٌ مِّن بَيْنِ يَدَيْهِ وَمِنْ خَلْفِهِ يَحْفَظُونَهُ مِنْ أَمْرِ اللَّهِ. He got angels coming in succession, one after the other, before the person and behind the person, يَحْفَظُونَهُ, and they protect him. مِنْ أَمْرِ اللَّهِ, by the decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There is another meaning of this ayah, that they protect him from each and every calamity and difficult times, except if something is decreed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then it is going to happen. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protects especially his friends. In Arabic, the friends are known as al-awliya, his friends, from all bad things, protects them from doing anything wrong, protects them from witnessing anything wrong, protects them at the time of misery and the time of trouble as well, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Al-Hafiz. Now this word Al-Hafiz, if the opposite of it is to neglect, which is in Arabic you can say, or to forget, An-Nisyan, then, as I just recited that ayah, Inna nahnu nazzalna dhikra wa inna lahu lahafidhun. So this Hifz is to protect or preserve, and in this case Al-Quran. And he said, قَالَ عِلْمُهَا إِنْدَ رَبِّي فِي كِتَابٍ لَا يَذِلُّ رَبِّي وَلَا يَنْسَى. When Pharaoh asked Musa alayhi salam, فَمَا بَالُ الْقُرُونِ الْأُولَى, what are the news of the people of the past? And Musa alayhi salam replied to him, "Ilmuha inda Rabbi fi kitabin la yadhillu Rabbi wa la yansa." The knowledge of that is with Allah, with my Lord, in a book. And my Lord, la yadhillu Rabbi, nothing can be omitted from his knowledge, and he is not going to forget anything. And if the opposite of it is to neglect something or to abandon something, then it can be applied as in this ayah. For example, the father of Yusuf alayhi salam, Yaqub alayhi salam, said, فَاللَّهُ خَيْرٌ حَافِظًا وَهُوَ أَرْحَمُ الرَّاحِمِينَ. Allah is the best to protect, and He is the most merciful among those who show mercy. So we said that sometime the meaning is to protect and preserve, and sometime the meaning is to watch. Another ayah of Al-Quran which shows that meaning, وَالَّذِينَ اتَّخَذُوا مِن دُونِهِ أَوْلِيَاءَ اللَّهُ حَفِيظٌ عَلَيْهِمْ. Those people who have taken protectors or friends beside Allah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is watching them. Allahu hafizun alayhim. Allah is watchful upon them. And in the same way, in the meaning of protection or to preserve a thing, we can take this saying of Sayyidina Yusuf alayhi salam addressing the king of Egypt when he said to him, Ij'alni ala khaza'in al-ard, inni hafizun alim. Make me a person in charge of all the treasures of the land, because I am hafizun, I can protect them, alimun, I got the knowledge about them. When we believe in this attribute of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what are those things which could be attributed to that name? First of all, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is guarding the whole universe, the heaven and the earth. وَلَا يَؤُدُهُ حِفْزُهُمَا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said, وَجَعَلْنَا السَّمَاءَ سَقْفًا مَحْفُوظًا وَهُمْ عَنْ آيَاتِهَا مُعْرِضُونَ. And we have made the heaven just like a ceiling, protected. But still, these people, means the infidels, those who reject the signs of Allah, they run away from the signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also said that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made the heaven protected from the interference of the Satans and the jinn. وَلَقَدْ جَعَلْنَا فِي السَّمَاءِ بُرُوجًا وَزَيَّنَّاهَا لِلنَّاظِرِينَ وَحَفِظْنَاهَا مِنْ كُلِّ شَيْطَانٍ رَجِيمٍ إِلَّا مَنِ اسْتَرَقَ السَّمْعَ فَأَطْبَعَهُ شِهَابٌ مُبِينٌ. And we have made in the heaven constellations, and we have beautified it for those people who look at it, and we have protected it from every cursed Satan, except any of them who tries to steal some of the revelation. فَأَتْبَاهُ شِهَابٌ مُبِينٌ. Then a burning flame is going to follow him. So he got no access to the heaven. That is what we understand from this name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and the impression which should be reflected in the man, in the believer, is that when he knows that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the protector, he should try also to protect the deen of Allah. He should try also to protect his prayer. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَحَافِظُوا عَلَى الصَّلَوَاتِ وَالصَّلَاةِ الْوُسْطَى. Protect your prayer, and especially the middle prayer. And normally it is said that the middle prayer is the Asr prayer, because there are two prayers before it, and you can say Fajr and Zuhr, and two after it, and that is Maghrib and Isha. And in the same way, a believer is the one who protects his chastity as well in the beginning of Surah Al-Mu'minun, and also in Surah Al-Ma'arij, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said, وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ لِفُرُوجِهِمْ حَافِظُونَ إِلَّا عَلَىٰ أَزْوَاجِهِمْ أَوْ مَا مَلَكَتْ أَيْمَانُهُمْ فَإِنَّهُمْ غَيْرُ مَلُومِينَ فَمَنِ ابْتَغَى وَرَاءَ ذَلِكَ فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْعَادُونَ The believers are those who are going to protect their chastity, their shames, except as far as their wives are concerned, are those women who are possessed by their right hands, means the captive ones. And beyond that, if they do anything else, and if they go beyond that, then they are going to be blamed. They would be held blameworthy for that. And in the end of this passage of Surah Al-Mu'minun and also the other surah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ عَلَىٰ صَلَوَاتِهِمْ يُحَافِظُونَ And those people who preserve their prayer, who protect their prayer. And how to protect your prayer, how to guard your prayer? Pray it at its due time. Don't delay it. Again, praying it in congregation, especially for the men folk, go to the mosque and pray there to get a great reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then pray with concentration. قَدْ أَفْلَهَ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ الَّذِينَ هُمْ فِي صَلَاتِهِمْ خَاشِعُونَ Those believers are successful. Those who got concentration, al-khushu in their prayer. Meaning that when once you enter into your prayer, you just forget what is around you. You are concentrating on the recitation of Al-Quran, either recited by you, or if you are in a congregational prayer, whatever you hear from your imam. Just concentrate upon it. And this is how you can beautify your prayer, and you can benefit from your prayer. Because if you keep on thinking about the worldly thing, about your home, about your wife, about your children, your prayer is going to be spoiled completely. This is why it is again and again said in Al-Quran and also by the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam that take care of your prayer. Because the first thing we are going to be asked on the Day of Judgment, that is the prayer. And if our prayer is found to be easy and sound and correct, then everything would be easy for us. And as Imam Ibn Qayyim has said, that for a person, there are two standing positions before Allah. One in this world, and that is your prayer mat when you converse with Allah. And one on the Day of Judgment, when you stand before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to answer the questioning. And he said that if you make your standing in this world and the prayer mat a good one, then the other stature, the other standing on the Day of Judgment would be very easy for you. Make your prayer good, and inshallah, the questioning would be very easy for you. And inshallah, we are going to meet after the break to complete speaking about the other name of Allah al-Muqit. Wassalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Allahu ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, al-Malik al-Quddus al-Salam, al-Mu'min al-Muhaymin al-Aziz al-Jabbar.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Before the break, we spoke about Al-Hafidh. And in this session, Let us take Al-Muqit. And we said right from the beginning that this is the attribute number 40 in that order which we are following in this series. Now the word Al-Muqit, that is mentioned only in one ayah of Al-Quran, and that is the ayah of Surah An-Nisa. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, مَنْ يَشْفَى شَفَاعَةً حَسَنَةً يَكُنْ لَهُ نَصِيبٌ مِّنْهَا وَمَنْ يَشْفَى شَفَاعَةً سَيِّئَةً يَكُنْ لَهُ كِفْلٌ مِّنْهَا وَكَانَ اللَّهُ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ مُقِيتًا. The person who intercedes for a good cause, a good intercession, he is going to have a portion of it, means the reward. And the person who does a bad intercession for a bad cause, yakullahu kiflum minha, he is going to take some burden of it. وَكَانَ اللَّهُ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ مُقِيتًا. And here muqita means muqtadira, qadira, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is able upon everything. Nothing is beyond his control. Everything is under his control. So that is the one meaning of the word muqit. But it is also from qut. As you know that the word qut in Arabic, that is the food itself. The food itself. So muqita can also mean Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who provides everyone with its food. This is why we can say al-muqit means the feeder. The first meaning, that is, as we said, that he is able upon everything. But according to the second meaning, he is the maintainer. He is the sustainer. He is the feeder who is feeding every creature here, whether they are human being, or animals, or beast, or insects, anything. The animal life, whether it is on the land, in the ocean, every one of them is fed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala according to its own needs. And that is the attribute of Allah, that he is giving everyone what that one needs it. Look at the difference of the food among the people and among the animals themselves. Everyone is happy with the food which is given to it. Now, as far as this word al-qut is concerned, let us take this hadith. It is reported that one of the free slave of Abdullah ibn Amr, he said to him, as you know, Abdullah ibn Umar, as he said to, this was a great sahabi of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said to him that I want to go to Jerusalem, Baytul Maqdis, and stay there for a month. Now the first question Abdullah asked him, "Hal tarakta li ahlika ma yaqutuhum hadha ash-shahr?" Have you left with your family the food for that month? He said, "No." Then he said, "Farji ila ahlik. Fatruk lahum ma yaqutuhum." Go back to your family and provide them with the food of 1 month. فَإِنِّي سَمِعْتُ رَسُولَ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ يَقُولُ, because I have heard the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم saying, كَفَى بِالْمَرْءِ إِثْمًا أَنْ يُضَيِّعَ مَنْ يَقُوتُ أَوْ أَنْ يُضِيءَ مَنْ يَقُوتُ. That is a sin enough for a man to waste those people who are under him, who are dependent upon him, who are asking food from him. So that becomes the duty of the man when he leaves his house for any purpose for a long time, that he should provide them with enough food. So what I meant here, that the word qut is definitely here, means the food. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is muqit, giving everyone the food what that thing requires. Now, the food is that thing by which you can be active, by which you can do your work. Without it, you can't operate in your work at all. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that is the one of the favors of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that He is providing you with all what you need in this life. Now this aspect that Allah provides everyone, that has been mentioned also in many verses of Al-Quran. Let us take this verse of Surah Hud. وَمَا مِن دَابَّةٍ فِي الْأَرْضِ إِلَّا عَلَى اللَّهِ رِزْقُهَا وَيَعْلَمُ مُسْتَقَرَّهَا وَمُسْتَوْدَعَهَا كُلٌّ فِي كِتَابٍ مُبِينٍ. There is no creature in the land, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has taken upon Himself to feed him, to give him his sustenance. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows where it stays, mustaqarraha, where it has to abide in. And also knows wa mustawda'aha, when he dies, where he is going to be deposited. For example, the burial place of the man. Or even if there is no burial place for any animal, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows where is this person or this cattle or this animal. Nothing is hidden from Allah. And everything, the knowledge of everything is in a book which is very clear and very manifest. Again, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also said about the food itself, that it has been estimated right from the beginning. The ayat of Surah Fussilat, which says about the creation of the earth, and then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has placed in it all the food which was needed, and later He turned to the heaven and He created the heaven. Let us take that part of the ayah. وَجَعَلَ فِيهَا رَوَاسِيَ مِن فَوْقِهَا وَبَارَكَ فِيهَا وَقَدَّرَ فِيهَا أَقْوَاتَهَا فِي أَرْبَعَةِ أَيَّامٍ سَوَاءً لِلسَّائِلِينَ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made upon the earth firmaments, means the mountains, and just to make it stationary and to make it stable. وَبَارَكَ فِيهَا, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed it, has placed barakah into it. وَقَدَّرَ فِيهَا أَقْوَاتَهَا, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has estimated all its food in it. فِي أَرْبَعَةِ أَيَّامٍ, in 4 days. سَوَاءً لِلسَّائِلِينَ, which is for all those who need it, who ask for it. For everyone, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has estimated that food which is going to be given to it. And that is another issue where we have to discuss about taqdeer, that word which is coming from qaddara fiha, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given an estimate of everything. And there is another word which is used in the Quran, which is qada. And when we combine them together, we say that qada wa qadar, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala estimated, that is taqdeer, and then He implemented what He estimated first. And this is just like the work of a person who wants to build a building. So first the planning is done, and in the plan itself, everything which is going to be in that building is estimated. The amount of iron, the amount of the bricks, the wood, the nails, and even the place of the wall, the place of the ceiling, the place of everything is shown in that plan. That is taqdeer, which is the estimation. And after that comes al-qada, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala implements what He has estimated. So this is another issue, but we are concerned here with al-qut, which we have taken from the word muqit. And we also should understand that the food is not only what you eat. That is one type of food. There are so many types of food. Spiritual food, for example. Your intellect, your mind, the faculty of your mind, in which people differ from one person to the other person. That is also a gift from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if a person is intelligent, he should be very thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that he has given him that intelligence. So he should exercise this intelligence for the sake of Allah, for the support of the deen, for doing what is good and creative and productive for the society. And in the same way, that person who got a lot of knowledges, and though he has worked hard and he acquired all these knowledges, but this is again a gift from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Many people, in the course of their study or because of the events, they go mental. And they are not able to do anything. They end up in a mental hospital. So who is going to save you from that end? If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has saved you and saved your intellect, then be thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Use your intellect, as I said, to serve the deen of Allah. Because majority of the people in this planet, as we know, those people who got good intelligence and those who have invented so many things, they have done something good. But still, there are many people who are using their intellect, their minds, to serve the purpose of the Satan. Every day and every night, they are devising new things to mislead the people. Look just at one aspect of what they are doing, the fashion, and how they are introducing every day a new fashion. And that fashion, it is just a following of the satanic way, exposing, especially for the women, to expose their bodies. And they must realize that they should not be deceived by these satanic devices. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you the guidance. You are in the light. That is the light of Al-Quran. There is no need for you to follow these fashions by which you go against the teachings of Al-Quran, the teachings of our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Save your skin, save yourself from the hellfire. That should be your prime objective in this life. And with this, we come to the end of this session. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Allahur Rahmanur Rahim, Al Malik Al Quddus Al Salam, Al Mu'min Al Muhaymin Al Aziz Al Jabbar. الله الرحمن الرحيم المالك القدوس السلام المؤمن المهيمن العزيز